Hi friends. In the previous video, we discussed about the types of the teeth, which was the classification on the basis of morphology, on the basis of morphology. Yes, on the basis of morphology, we know we have two classes of teeth. The first class is homodont. In homodont teeth, the organisms, teeth, all the teeth have same shape. The second class is heterodont. In heterodont, the organism have one organism in its oral cavity have different types of different shapes of teeth. So the first shape, the first type of teeth was incisors. The second type was canines, and the third type was premolars. The fourth one is molars. Yes, this was our previous classification. Now in this video we are classifying the teeth in an other way. That is, the second classification is on basis of teeth eruption. Okay friends, on the basis of teeth eruption means on the basis of on the basis in which the teeth arise, forms and arise from the gums or from the jaw. So yes, on this basis teeth are classified as, the first one is monohyodont means mono means one. Now one means once. In monohyodonts, the teeth arise one time and remains for the life. Yes, monohyodont means teeth arise once and if fall out never arise again. Yes, these are the organisms in which the teeth arise once in life and remains for whole life. And if the teeth are fall out, then they never arise again. Such type of organisms are called monohyodonts. And the examples of monohyodonts are platypus and moles. Organisms platypus and moles. These organisms have teeth which are monohyodonts. The next class is polyhyodonts. Poly means many times. Here poly means many times. Yes. So it is clear from this word that in these organisms the teeth appear many times. Yes. Teeth appear many times in lifespan. The examples of these organisms are crocodiles. Crocodiles have teeth which are falling and arising. So crocodiles come in the class of polyhyodonts. In the next class is number 3. Then the basis of teeth eruption is dihyodonts. Yes, Die means two times. Die means two times. Two times, yes. In these organisms, the teeth appear in two stages of life. The first stage is in the months, in the sixth or seventh month, the teeth appear and they remain for 6 or 7 years. After that, these teeth fall out and next class of teeth appear, next group of teeth appear and they remain for the whole life. Yes. In diastereodonts, teeth appear in two stages of life. The first stage is in the first stage of teeth eruption, the age of the baby may be 4, 6, 7 or little more years, months. They remain, these teeth remain for 6 years of age. In the seventh year of age, these teeth, the first class of teeth fall out and the next class of teeth appear. Those remain for the whole life. Yes. Diastereodonts. In diastereodonts, the teeth appear two times. In monastereodonts, once in life and remain for whole life. In polystereodonts, many times. Teeth are falling and appear, falling and appearing again. In diastereodonts, the teeth once appear, they fall out. And then appear the teeth, they remain for the whole life. Yes. Examples of these organisms are human beings. Human beings are diastereodonts. The first class of teeth which appear are called temporary teeth, milk teeth, deciduous teeth or primary teeth. Yes. The first class is, in these organisms, the first class is primary teeth, primary or we can say temporary teeth, or we can say milk teeth, or we can say deciduous teeth. Yes, friends, deciduous teeth or teeth. Okay, so in diastereodonts, the first class of teeth which have, the first type of teeth which appear are called primary teeth, or we can say temporary teeth, because they are temporary, because they remain for a very short duration of life and then fall out. Milk teeth means when they appear after 7 months of age, when the baby is taking milk of mother. And deciduous teeth, right? So these teeth, for these teeth we have formulas. Okay, let's write. They appear at seventh month of age and fall out at seventh year of age. And many children's, I'm writing 7 and 7, and many children's and many babies, they are seen that they appear at the seventh month of age and fall out in the seventh month of, this is the average. Right. So, how many teeth are these? We have formula for them. The formula is 2102 divided by 2102 multiply by 2, which becomes total 20 teeth. Right. So the first or primary teeth in babies are 20. What are these? The first two are incisors. The next one is canine. The zero shows premolars, and the two shows molars. Yes. So this is for upper jaw, this is for lower jaw, and we multiply them by 2, total becomes 20 teeth. How? Let's count. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 0, yes, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. Okay, 5 multiplied by 2, 10. Let's come here. 5 multiplied by 2, 10. 10 plus 10, 20. 10 plus 10, the primary teeth in children's are 20 in number. Yes, these are the organisms which have, and in these organisms the teeth appear in two stages of life. The first stage, the first type of teeth which appear at the seventh month of age and remains for seventh year of the age. These teeth are called primary, temporary, or milk or deciduous teeth. The formula for such teeth is this one. Let's focus our camera here. And the second class of dihydrant teeth are secondary teeth, or we can say they are not temporary, they are permanent teeth. They are permanent teeth and they are non-deciduous teeth. Non-deciduous teeth. Right. Okay, friends. So they appear at seventh year of age. Non-deciduous or secondary or permanent teeth appear at the seventh year of age and remains for whole life. These teeth remains for whole life. And the formula for these teeth is 2, 1, 2, 3 divided by, sorry, not divided by, 2, 1, 2, 3 multiplied by 2. Okay. The first two shows incisors, then canines, then premolars, and then molars. Okay. So we count 2 canine, 1 premolar, 2 plus 1, 3. Then 2 premolars, 5. Then 3 molars. Total become 8. Okay, let's see this formula here in the diagram. We have this. This is our lower jaw, for example. We have, yes, the first two. We have 2 incisors. Then we have 1 canine. And then we have 2, yes, premolars. And then we have 3 molars. Okay. Total becomes 8. So if we have 8 in this right side, left side, we also have 8 in this side. So 8 plus 8 equals 16. 16 in the lower jaw, 16 in the upper jaw. Total becomes 8. Total becomes 32 teeth. Yes. So 32 teeth are the number of permanent teeth in these organisms. Okay, friends. In the first video, we classified the teeth according to their morphology. In this video, we classified the teeth on the basis of eruption or replacement. On the basis of eruption or replacement, teeth may be monohydont. In monohydonts, the organisms, in these organisms, the teeth appear once in life and they remain for whole life. In the polyhydont teeth, the teeth are arising and falling. So, in these organisms, the teeth arise many times. Examples are crocodiles. In dihydont organisms, the teeth appear in two stages of life, and that is, they appear in the seventh month of age and then appear at the seventh year of age and remain for the whole life. Yes, the examples of dihydronts are we humans. Humans are dihydronts. higher drones. Okay, friends. We can classify the teeth in a third classification, which is very short. Focus our camera here. The third classification will be, let's make it short. The third classification will be on basis of attachment, on basis of attachment to, yes, to gums, on basis of attachment to gums. This is our third classification. So on the basis of attachment to gum, I am showing you diagrammatically, and I will write their name. The first class is, for example, if this is the gum, this is the gum, and the teeth is present here. This is the teeth. This is the tooth. And this is the gum. Right. So the first class is this one. And these organisms are called acrodonts. These are, the first one is acrodont. This is called acrodont. What is acrodont? Acrodonts are the organisms which have the teeth attached to the free surface of the gums. Okay. The next class is, for example, if this is the gum and the teeth are attached to one side of the gum. The teeth are attached to one side of the, this is the tooth. This is the tooth. And this is the gum, right? So these organisms in which the tooth is attached to one side of the gum, such organisms are called pleurodonts. Pleurodonts. And the third class is we humans. The teeth are, this is gum and this is other gum. The teeth are attached to both sides of the gums. This is our third class. Right? Like this or simply like this. This is our teeth. Okay. In this class, the teeth is attached to two sides of the bones or gums. Such class is called thecodont. Thecodonts. Yes, friends. In thecodonts, the teeth is attached to two sides of the bone or gums. And pleurodonts, the tooth is attached to one side. And the acrodonts, the tooth is present on the free surface of the gum or the alveolar process of the bone. Okay, friends, this was the classification of teeth. I hope you like this video. Friends, it is a very humble request to every one of you that please write some comments that we can improve our lectures according to your choice. So if you like the video, please subscribe the channel, hit the like button and press the bell icon to get more and more videos. Thank you so much.